Good evening, all. Good evening. So, guys, finally we are here. So today is already 13th of June and 14 days to go for your first NPAT attempt, 27th of June. So how many of you are writing their first attempt on 27th of June? Can I have a few raise of hands? Oh my God, that's huge. Great. So I'm just talking about 27th. Yeah. So I can see almost roughly 50% of the participants right now present are going to write their first attempt on 27th of June. So guys, I'm here just to give you few last moment tips that you should, you know, follow in this last 14 days that will really help you out to crack NPAT with the desired score. And finally, you guys achieve your desired college. Okay. So I'm sure you guys, Farhan, Symbiosis is not happening on 27th of June. Yes, we are allowed two attempts for NPAT, Aman. 27th. So I'll just show you the dates quickly. Let's start the session, guys. So these are the important key dates for your NPAT 21 this year. Registration deadline is still 17th of June. So whoever in your friend circle has still not registered, they can still register for the NPAT 21 intake. Then registration link is npat.in. And these are the test windows, 27 June, 2nd and 3rd July. So you can book two dates out of three. Okay. You can book two dates out of three and the best out of the two will be considered. Okay. Symbiosis is between 10 to 13, guys. That is what the tentative date for Symbiosis as of now of July. 10 to 13 July is the window. For that, if anybody wants to change the day for a date for NPAT, you have to please email NMIMS or call them up once. Okay. Obviously, they'll charge you again for that. So make sure we do all the registration formalities nicely and don't miss out on any important date. Okay, so we are not going to talk about Symbiosis. All the deadlines are mentioned on the IMS portal. Please go to the My IMS portal. All the deadlines for all the colleges are mentioned over there. So let's start, guys. So test pattern, guys, NPAT 21, we know overall we have three sections. You have 40 questions, 14 maths, 14 English, and 14 logical reasoning. Okay. And the marks are, questions are 120, your marks are 120, one mark for each question, one mark for every correct answer, no negative, no sectional time limit, and no sectional cutoff. So overall, you have just 100 minutes to answer 120 questions. So last year, guys, last year NPAT, I'll just give a small background what happened last year NPAT. An online CALCI was available. On-screen calculator, okay? Not the offline one. On-screen calculator was there. Whether this will be there this year or not, I don't know. Nothing has been mentioned on the website yet. And last year what happened? Let's say you started with the section English. So, no, you can't use. Calculators are not at all allowed, guys. They in fact provided with an on-screen calculator last year NPAT. Okay. Now, last year it was, let's say you enter the English section first. So if you want to go to the LR section, you will have to submit the English section. That means you cannot swap between the two sections again and again. So whichever section you first start with, make sure that we complete that particular section first and then go to the next section. So when the instructions are finally out, please make sure that we read the instructions very carefully and then take it ahead. What will be the instructions for this year? We will have to still wait. This is last year I'm talking about. Last year on-screen calculator was available. And the moment you enter a section, if you want to go to the next section, you have to submit that section. And you cannot come back to the previous section then. Let's say if you started with verbal and you submitted the paper after 20 minutes, you cannot come back to verbal again. Okay, then you will take the LR or maths, whichever you want. So make sure this year also, once the paper is going to start, we read the instructions very carefully. Okay. Yes. Because it was home proctored. That's the reason. Yes, you will be getting a rough paper and pens. You will be allowed to use your rough paper and pen for your calculations. Now, talking about what will be a good score, this is a question that I normally get from a lot of students. What should be a good score in, you know, NPAT? Now, the thing is, NPAT authorities do not reveal the cutoff. If you check for the official website, they have never ever disclosed the cutoff for any program across any campus. So based on the students who get a shortlist for any of the programs, this is what we have been eventually getting from the students, the projected scores. Okay, I'm very sure that I'm going to get 85 rights, and he was shortlisted for the program. So on an average, what we recommend students, a safe score should be 70% of 120, which is 84 and above. So your target score should not be lesser than 84. So ideally, I tell students you should target 90 to 95, so that finally we land around, 84, 85 marks. Okay. Now, across various sections, important is the time management, guys. Ideal scenario, how you should use this 100 minutes is the key here. So for English, according to us, 20 to 25 minutes max you should spend on the verbal section. Again, in verbal section, I get a question from students asking that, sir, should we start with RC first or at the end? So guys, what I will recommend, first you try the non-RC questions and then try to RC towards the end of this particular section. Second, ideal time frame to crack your logical reasoning, 30 to 35 minutes max should be spent on logical reasoning. Having said that, 35 over here and 25 over here, I am done with 60 minutes, which is 1 hour. So if I manage my LR and English section in good 55 to 60 minutes, then I have good amount of time for quant, which is 40 to 45 minutes, which is required also because that will be the most time consuming section in NPAT. So if I just leave 20 to 25 minutes for maths, I will not get a good score in quant. So I have to make sure that in an hour's time, I finish my LR and English section so that I have good 40 minutes left for my quant section. So if you're planning to attempt around 27 to 30 questions and we're working around 80 to 85% accuracy, we touch a score of 21 to 24. I'm not saying this should be a target score, but this is the minimum that you guys should target. Some students have been getting a score of 32 also, 34 also, 29 also in quant section. Higher the better, of course, but this is the minimum score, guys, you should target across the various sections. So if you target a 24 in a quant, 30 in logical reasoning and a 32 here, we are in that safe zone of crossing 84 marks. Okay, so this is a minimum score, guys, that you should plan. The timing is very important. How are we going to utilize this for 100 minutes? Now, some of the students are really good at quant. So they start with quant section first, spending 40 minutes. Now don't, spend an hour in quant. Do you think if you spend 1 hour for quant, will you be able to cover your LR and English in 40 minutes? Is that possible? Is that possible, guys? So don't ever work with a strategy that can go against you in the exams. So please decide the amount of time that you're going to spend. See, 2-3 minutes here and there is understood, but you can't make 40 minutes to 60 minutes. 40 ka 45 hoga is still okay. So that I have good 55 minutes, I can still crack my LR and English section. And if you're starting with English and LR, don't spend 80 minutes in English and LR. I'm sure that must be the case with few students. They start with English and LR, but they spend 75-80 minutes. Is that the case with anybody here? That you spend around 75-80 minutes in English and LR? You see, I'm getting a lot of raise of hands. So guys, we have to really work upon our speed, yes, in English and LR section. So max to max, what I recommend, you have to try and finish your English and LR section in good 55-60 minutes. You will have to keep 40 to 45 minutes for quant. Okay. Then important topics. Now, these are the important topics that's a must. You should target these topics. So whoever has, not yet studied a chapter like functions or a chapter like set theory, please start working on this chapter, guys. So important topics, quant and numerical ability asked in the last year paper only. 4 to 7 questions each were asked across these topics. So last year, there were 4 slots, NPAT 2020. Statistics, functions, trigo, set theory, numbers, profit, percentage and loss, profit and loss. 2 to 3 questions you had on progressions, couple of questions on TSD and couple of questions on probability and 1 each on SICI, quadratic, time and work. So this was the breakup of the quant section last year NPAT 2020. Considering these are important topics and they are really important, I'm sure your mentors must have told you that these are the must a chapter that you should definitely target. There is no if and but, and you should leave this particular chapter. Okay. Yes, yes, Srishti, you can attempt both the NPAT attempts. The best out of the two will be considered. Now, some students are asking me, sir, which should be the first section? You should always start with the section that you are most comfortable with. If you are extremely good in English, please start with your paper with English, followed by logical reasoning, and then we can keep quant 40 minutes towards the end. So it's up to us which section am I more comfortable with. Okay. Then important topics which were asked in last year NPAT 2020. As you know, DI is a part of logical reasoning. So last year you had 10 questions which were spreaded across three DI sets. One was on pie, one was tables, and one was mixed charts. Then you get 4 to 5 questions on selection criteria, DS. DS is very important, guys. Are you guys doing DS or not? Data sufficiency. Please do it. Very, very important. You will see minimum 3 to 4 questions on data sufficiency. So please start doing it. Okay, SILOGs, a favorite topic. They'll ask you questions on SILOGs for sure. Venn diagram, visual reasoning, logical inequality. I'm sure you guys know A greater than or equal to B, less than C. You need to establish the relationship between A and B. Okay. Now, apart from this, you get a couple of questions on arrangements, order ranking, family tree, operations, mathematical operations. Now, sometimes this arrangement set can be time consuming. Yes or no, guys? So specifically in logical reasoning, what I've come across, the arrangement set turns out to be on the difficult side. So it's okay. That will be one set max. So we can first try and target the remaining questions, completing the selection criteria, the DI part, the Venn diagram, your logical inequality, and then maybe you can try your arrangement set towards the end. If time does not permit and you're very well sure about 35 questions, I'm done, then you may skip that set also, depending upon how much time do you have. And if you see the set, you know, you've spent 2 minutes, but you're not able to crack it, please leave it, guys. You should not do that. And if you know that you're not good at arrangements, don't even bother to solve that. But make sure that we solve the remaining questions nicely. That is very important. Okay. And verbal reasoning, as you know, statement conclusions, couple of questions, deductive reasoning, couple of questions. This was the pattern last year. Okay. So this was the spread of all your 40 questions in the reasoning section. Then coming to your verbal section, 15 questions were on RCs. So good 300, 400 words, 5 to 6 on your filling the blanks, parts of speech, preposition, sentence completion, and 4 questions each on sentence correction, parajumbles, and your this. So what I will recommend in English, first your target area should be this particular questions, and then maybe keeping your RCs towards the end of the section. Okay. Yes, of course, Aman, since there is no negative marking in NPAT, you should attempt each and every question. Moderate to hard. Yes, it can be moderate to hard, Meg. One of the question RC passages might be easy. The other can be easy to medium or medium to difficult. Possible. Yeah, Saurabh, why not? Yes, last year it was home proctored. Last year also NPAT, the students were allowed to take the test from home because of the lockdown and all. This year also they are allowing the students to take the test from home only. You will get all the set of instructions. Everything will be given to you. Don't worry. Okay. See, nothing like it, Manan. We'll have to still wait for the official communication. We'll have to call up the contact history once. No. See, talking about virtual notepad or not, as I said, as you guys know, from 17 June onwards, I think till 21st of June, they're going to give you a demo mock, if I'm not wrong, right? These are the instructions which they have given on the official website. Is everybody aware about that? Yes. 17 to 21. So all your doubts, whatever you have, 22, okay. I may have missed up one date. So all your doubts about the mocks, how is the mock going to be conducted? Will you have a CALCI or not? What is the number of sheets, virtual notepad or not? All your doubts and difficulties will get cleared in this section. So don't worry, hold on, okay? Please. Cheating, tum log decide karo kya karna hai. Don't ever get into that, you know, thing of bothering others. Be yourself during the day of the paper, guys. Strongly recommended. Yeah, LR topics, I'll show it again. These were the LR topics, guys. they watch you over the webcam. So make sure we are just giving a test. 100 minutes should be utilized fruitfully. Okay. No, you can't take all the three slots. You have to pick two out of three. Now, this is the important topics in English. Now, coming to the tip number one, take online NBAT mock test, which I'm sure you guys must have already started taking your mocks. Whoever is still thinking to take the mock, please guys, start now. It's high time that we start taking the mocks. We don't have that much time left. Whoever is targeting the ATEM 127, it's the time that we get into that zone of taking the mocks. Take one mock per week. Now it will be a lesser amount of time. We have only 14 days and we have all the 10 mocks to be utilized. So every 2 days you will have to take a mock. Now, very important guys, whenever you take a mock, important is to analyze the mock. If I don't analyze the mock and just keep on taking mock by mock without analyzing it, it will make no sense. So if you spend 100 minutes to take a mock, believe me, you have to spend at least good 3 to 4 hours to analyze the mock. Learn from the mistakes wherever possible. Okay, this 5 questions in quant, why didn't I get these 5 questions? These were very simple questions. Maybe you were not able to see the question because of time constraint, or maybe you thought the question in some other sense, but actually it turned out to be a very simple question, which happens, you know, once you analyze the mock, you realize that there was a potential that I could have increased my score around 8 to 10 marks. Does that happen with you guys? Whoever analyzes the mock, do you see that there was a potential to improve the score? So we should do that a lot. Yes, we should do that. So analyzing the mocks is really important. Identifying your weaker areas, very, very important. So just a simple example. Let's say you've taken 4 mocks. Okay. So you will see that in arithmetic, continuously, accuracy is only around 40 to 50% across all the mocks, mock 1, 2, 3, 4. That means this is an area that you need to really work upon. So whoever has taken, let's say, 3 mocks or even 4 mocks, you can analyze the geometry section across all the mocks. If geometry is around 60%, that means I still have more chance, or, you know, this is my section which can be still improved, guys. So that is how you should analyze your mocks. Number system. Okay, I'm at 80%. That means more or less you are very well, you know, comfortable with the number system. Higher maths, only 20%. That means I need to work upon higher maths. Very, very important. So whoever has taken 3 to 4 mocks now, analyze section by section, guys. How is arithmetic going on? How is geometry going on? How is numbers going on? So that will make you understand which are my weaker areas and start working on those topics. As you know, we have all the concept videos available. The live recordings are available. So again, watch the concept videos. Watch the live recordings. And please, guys, you should finish all your 10 NPAT mocks. No if and but. Don't keep your mocks. We are not going to keep mocks for any other family members, right? It is for you. So make sure we utilize the mocks nicely. Revisit the study material. Attend the concept classes if required. If you feel that I need to brush up my concepts, please do it, guys. Okay? Now, tip number two, the section which is the most time consuming and a lot of students have fear in this section, quantitative ability, guys. Revise, these topics are really important. Stats, trigo, set theory, ABGP, indices, numbers, percentage, profit loss, average, and all. So these are the topics that you guys should definitely do it, guys. There is no option that you can think of even skipping this particular topics. You have to do it. It is the most time consuming section, but this is also one of the key section to ace the NPAT. See, you can't get an 85 or a 90 just because of logical reasoning and English. Is it possible to score an 85 in logical reasoning and verbal? Right? Not. So we have to give importance to this particular section. So I can't be just, you know, focusing only on LR and English. Guys, all the sections are equally important. So we have to give equal importance to across all the 3 sections. Don't just keep studying English, logical reasoning, and avoid maths. Will not help you. So you should complete all your topic-wise tests. If you haven't completed for this particular section, make sure you revise the concepts, finish your workbook questions, module questions, and then come to the topic-wise test. And please practice your offline book on your advanced maths practice module. If we haven't solved this book yet, make sure we finish all the chapters from this advancements practice module. Okay. Tip number three, English section. Now for RCEs, focus on the reading speed, guys. Most questions are direct. So it is better that we first read the questions and then search for that particular answer in the passages. I'm sure you guys are working on this tip, right? If not, you can start doing this. Really helps you to, you know, save a lot of time. Both, Naman, you have to take both. Revise grammar rules, very important. Practice para jumbles because you will definitely see questions on para jumbles. Good command over the vocabulary will help you solve word meaning in the context of the sentence type question. So again, in English section, make sure we first try to complete the non-RC questions and then we have time left to solve the RC question towards the end of the English section. Okay, keep practicing, revising your grammar rules, very important. Para-jumble questions, must do. You can't skip these things for English section. I'm sure most of the students are, you know, much comfortable in the English section. Yes or no, guys? Are you guys scoring good marks in English section? Yes. Majority of the students are, you know, doing really good as far as the English section is concerned. That is what I have observed. Good. Tip number four, reasoning, guys. Revise tables, practice approximation because this will help you to crack the DI sets. As you know, you get around 3 sets, around 10 questions in DI. So I have to be very sure about how to take approximation, how to do percentage calculation, how to take averages, how do you compare ratios? Because sometimes you get a question, profit upon sales is highest across which year? So I need to be very comfortable as far as the comparison of the fraction is concerned. So I need to practice and work on my table revision, revising my reciprocals 1/2, 1/3, because sometimes you might get a fraction like 3/8, which is 37.5%. So I need to know what is 37.5%. You might see 37.5% quietly used in the lot of questions. So I need to know, okay, 37.5% is 3/8. We should do that. Okay. Please practice DS questions. Minimum, what I have seen, you will see 3 to 4 questions minimum on data sufficiency. So please make sure that we solve enough questions on data sufficiency so that we don't lose these 4 marks, and data sufficiency questions are very much solvable. So you should get 4 on 4 if you get 4 questions on data sufficiency. Arrangements, again, guys, that will purely depend how deep the set is, what conditions have they given. If the set is, you know, involving 10 people, you know, 5 sitting outside, 5 sitting inside, a lot of conditions. So you may not start this set at the start of the logical reasoning section. You can complete the remaining questions and maybe then you can come back to the arrangement set towards the end. Selection criteria is doable, provided that we read the instructions, you know, very carefully. Visual reasoning, guys, again, it will all depend. Am I able to identify the pattern or not? It is almost similar to number series. Yes or no, guys? In number series also, what do? We try for the pattern. If I am able to crack in good 30, 40 seconds, I will do it. Otherwise, I will have to go to the next question. That same goes for visual reading. I need to understand what is happening, how many objects are coming, what is happening, moving clockwise, anti-clockwise, and so on. Then Venn diagram questions, couple of questions, as well as on family tree and syllogs. So these are the must-do topics for your reasoning section, guys. And the last tip, guys, during the test, very, very, very important. Start with the section. As I said, a lot of students have this question, sir, which section should I start my paper? In which your attempts and accuracy are the highest. So tell me, guys, now, 14 days to go, which will be your first section to start with? Majority of the students are saying English, majority. Second, I will say logical reasoning. Maths to ko interested in ye starting mein karne mein. Public maths last mein karne wali. Very few students with quant first. Me, sir. Okay, Sharan. No, I'm not saying, guys, don't start with quant first. See, what I'm saying is always start with a section which you feel that you can attempt good number of questions with good accuracy. That is also important, guys. I can't be just relying on speed, speed, speed. Yeah, if you get that time, Manan, very good. Then I think you should be able to attempt more or less all the questions. I have tendency to read the questions in maths and RCs in English before I solve and understand. No, Janvi, so better you don't do that. It may be considered against you, right, Janvi? So don't do that. Do we need to make any changes from our side for the people who registered 4th July? Nothing, Hazel. You don't have to do anything. Automatically, whoever registered for a 4th July, now it has changed to 3rd July. That's it. You don't have to do anything from your end. Nothing to be done. Okay? No, Sanjana. Then read every question, guys, and decide whether you want to do it or leave it. So a lot of students ask me, sir, if I am not sure about a question, should I mark it? Yes, you have to mark it. The questions which you feel are C category, chhodne wala category hai, usko to dabhi ka dabhi mark kar do. Because you will not get time to come back to that question again. But for the questions which you feel like are B category, baad mein karna hai, to usko mark karke rakho ya likhke rakho side pe, and we'll come back to those questions. So read every question, decide to do it immediately, which is A type, jo hum tabhi ka tabhi solve karenge. Mark it later for B attempt, or mark randomly if you feel that nahi nahi hone wala hai mere se, to mark karke aage jao. And proceed C type. Since you have no idea how to solve it, you should definitely mark those questions. Jai Mata Di and next question. Okay. Now in reasoning section, careful selection of question and constant eye on ticking clock matters. So if you start your reasoning section with arrangement set, that can go against you, right? If you are very not sure ki mein se crack hoga ke nahi hoga, so don't be the dilemma of starting with your logical reasoning section with arrangement set. Okay, don't do that, guys. Attempt one section completely, then move to the later section. A lot of students have a question on this. So guys, I'm again repeating the same thing. Last year, if you want to go from one section to the other one, you cannot come back to the previous section. So please make sure whatever section you start with, you complete that entire section and then move to the next section. Now in this window from 17 to 22, you'll come to know is swapping allowed between the sections or not. So please make sure that we read all the instructions carefully. Okay. You will get the choice, Sachi. You will get the choice. So as I said, which section to start, you get a choice or not. Normally you get a choice. So now in this window from 17 to 22, you will get all your doubts cleared in that. Don't worry. Mock platform. See, last year what happened? They in fact, gave you a link where you were supposed to download a platform, and on that platform the test was conducted. So we will have to still wait. What are they going to inform you? So how are they going to conduct the test and everything will be informed to you guys. So you guys chill out now. Don't worry about how are they going to conduct. You focus on your exams. Extraordinary questions people ask. There is no requirement of those questions. See guys, we are not conducting the test. IMS is not conducting, guys. They are conducting the test. So they will be the right person to answer your these questions. How many sheets they will allow? Will they allow on-screen calculator or not? That purely depends how are they going to conduct the exam. Correct? So just wait. 17th, you'll automatically come to know how are they going to conduct the test. Okay? No idea, Omer. Then go on, Rushabh. Of course, go on. If your Wi-Fi goes in between, they are not held responsible. You are held responsible. So game is over. So wo sab mat socho. Negative mat socho. Hum negative bahut sochte hain, guys. Why do you want to think on the negative part? Okay. So there is no negative marking, guys. So please attempt all the questions. Don't leave a single question. Very, very important. Are Shubham, there are three dates. You guys don't know second and third. So you can book any two dates out of three, and the best out of the two will be considered. Okay. That, of course, Ayush, they will inform you. How can I inform you about that, Ayush? Obviously, if Christ is coming up, we'll have to focus on Christ woman first. Right? So no negative marking, guys. Please attempt all the questions. And that's it, guys. So I'm sure you guys have got few tips as how are you supposed to take your mocks and what should be the strategy for your NPAT exam. Thank you so much, guys. Please take care, and wishing you all the best, guys.